This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today we are in Honduras. We're at La Casa Verde, which is Wendy Green's lovely property here, right on the Rio
Congrejal.
And this place is so beautiful that we actually looked at property here. Unfortunately, the property was probably the steepest property this north of the equator. So we're not getting property, but we're going to spend it with Wendy here. And Wendy's actually going to show us all the different fruit trees and all the amazing plants and jungle, just species that are here on this property. So let's rock and roll.
I'm really fortunate because when I bought this property, it was just loaded with fruit already. So I consider myself blessed.
Uh-huh.
Let's take a look at this guanabana,
uh-huh.
which looks like it belongs somewhere from the dinosaur age, right? This is a little baby guanabana doing its thing. For those of you who have eaten this before, you know that when you cut it open, it's kind of like ice cream. Warm ice cream is what it tastes like. It's really awesome. Right behind us here is a rambutan, or also a lychee. This produces in April. So here we are in January. Got a little ways to go before that starts rocking.
Uh-huh.
Well, this looks a grand grandma of a mango tree.
No, I honestly didn't know the mango trees grew this big. How tall is that? Probably about 25, 30 feet, maybe? Maybe more?
Oh, I would think maybe more. Maybe.
Wow. Yeah, well, and this produces mangoes, but...
It doesn't really.
I think it doesn't.
She's a little worn out.
Okay. She's a little tired.
Yeah, she's been doing that for a while now.
Uh-huh.
Cool. Let's go over here to the bananas.
Uh-huh. Wendy literally has like every single tropical fruit you can imagine here.
Yeah. So here are two racks of bananas going
look at
on.
These.
In different states of...
These aren't sprayed.
Goodness. No, not at all. This is fairly new. See, what happens is that... This flower creates these little things here, and then these little things create bananas. Isn't that wild? So actually the fruit is just part of the flower.
Wow.
This is a Suriname cherry, which is also a Cerulean cherry.
Oh, wow.
They look like little tiny pumpkins.
Yeah.
There's some just starting off here, you can see.
Listen to that bird.
Yeah.
That's actually Rio. That's Wendy's dog with a little
toy.
When we first came here, we thought that it was actually some sort of tropical creature, and we asked Wendy, what is this?
It is a tropical creature.
Yeah, it is a tropical creature. A dog with a squeeze toy.
But I have been picking cherries on this, and then there'll be birds at the top of the tree, mom at the bottom of the tree. So everybody enjoys this.
Great source of vitamin C.
Yeah, one of the best of things.
Mm-hmm.
Here we got a little papaya. Oh, this is a big papaya, and it was done. So we cut off the top, and it's going to sprout again. Looks like we're going to get quite a few sprouts off of this. It's really cool.
These leaves are amazing.
Yeah. Here's one papaya down low, and we've got, four or five up top, and those beautiful little flowers. We've got a ton of papaya on the property. Yeah, so these also take quite a bit to ripen.
Now these also grow off the tree like the cacao does.
Yeah, right.
Is it a similar family? Yeah.
Well, I don't know if it's a similar family, but it is a similar style.
Oh yeah, and there's the waterfall from the back here. This is like the little courtyard here. Absolutely amazing.
And to the left there is a really wonderful grapefruit tree.
It just produces
thousands and thousands of fruit. And then over to the right, on the other side of the waterfall, here in front of the house, is a cashew nut tree, which also produces.
Wait, which one?
This one right here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
We don't have anything on it now, but really rocking in the summer.
Now, do you break them open and?
You have to.
Do all the
acid.
Yeah.
I've actually been eating the fruit. It's really interesting. It's got like a little wet hair kind of thing, and then the nuts at the bottom of it, like an afterthought.
Right.
Cool. And the fruit is delicious, tangy.
Mm-hmm.
And then nuts I just kind of saved because they have an acid and you have to let them dry a long time before you open them up and you can actually burn yourself.
Right.
So when we finally did open them up, the nuts were like this tangy.
Oh, really? Not the ones that you see in the health food store.
Here we are, gardenias are just starting to go off.
What are they again?
Gardenias.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Right. Just beginning.
Mm-hmm.
This is our nutmeg tree. We actually have a male and female.
Okay.
So they can pollinate. This is the male, the little guy. And then the female, that's a big one, and she's the one who produces.
Oh, yeah.
And wait till you see what we've got here. We actually, the little fruit is like this. It almost looks like a peach or something, but this is just a husk.
It does look like a peach.
And then the husk opens and reveals the nut. Now the nut is covered with mace. Let me take this. This is ready to go.
Wow,
crazy,
look at that red.
Right?
I just got bit by an ant.
Me too.
Now, wow.
The mace looks like a brain, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. That's incredible.
And mace has the same, it almost looks like wax or plastic, but this is the way it is. It's a soft membrane. Now we take the mace off. You can dry the mace, and that has a slightly different flavor than the nut.
It smells nice.
And then we'll dry this in the sun. And this is a husk. And we crack it, and then the nut's on the inside.
Huh. And you grind it?
And you grind it. It looks brainy. And nutmeg is a very powerful spice. And it has been known to have some kind of psychotropic
what?
Benefits?
Benefits, yeah. yeah. I don't know what you call it.
But it looks like a brain, and I think it's really funny that it affects your brain as well. So that's pretty interesting.
Cool. It smells amazing.
Yeah, isn't that just crazy?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. That smells incredible.
Wow. Let me feel this.
It's like plastic.
It is like plastic.
It's rubbery.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty, right?
Gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. All right, everyone. I hope you enjoyed that tour. We've been here for, what, 4 or 5 days now?
I think so.
And we didn't even know that all these things existed. And if we did, we'd probably be out picking all. But I do want to tell you that this not only is an amazing property, but it also is a retreat center that Wendy has put together. There's a guest house. There's a house up here. There's this beautiful river in the background here. It's the Rio Cangrejal, which is I'm getting very used to speaking. And Wendy's also a yoga practitioner.
Ashtanga.
Oh man, I had it before. Ashtanga yoga practitioner, and we've been doing yoga every day here and really opening up some channels that I never knew could be opened up, which is a testament to Wendy's abilities here. So if you would like, you can get more information about Wendy. Why don't you tell us where someone can get more information?
Okay, great. I have a website, wendygreenyoga.com. So go ahead and check that out. We do raw food, we do nature, yoga and chill.
Yes.
Jungle and chill. That's what we do here.
Absolutely.
Cool.
So we're not going to do... Oh, hold on. So we're not going to do a question of the day. We're actually going to do an action of the day today. And the action of today is go to wendygreenyoga.com and check out some of the things that she has there. And if it maybe interests you, send her an email and see what you guys can do. I've been here for Emery and I have been here for 4 or 5 days. And let me tell you, the relaxation and just the sound of the river and the nature and the fruit and the food and the people, just absolutely, in the yoga, absolutely amazing. So, with all that said, this is Kevin Gianni and...
All of us. Hey!
Yes, together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.